Rocks are found in every place on Earth, from the top of the mountains to the bottom of the sea. But what are rocks? Let's find out, because rocks are way cool. Rocks are made of one or more minerals. Minerals are solid matter found in nature, thus the term rock solid. Minerals are the basic building blocks of the Earth. Minerals are found in the Earth's soil, rocks, and water. Minerals are inorganic, which means they are not alive. They don't need air, water, or food. Scientists have identified over 3,000 different minerals. They come in all different colors, shapes, and sizes. If you visit a cavern, you can actually see rocks being formed from minerals. As acidic rainwater finds its way underground, little by little, the mineral calcite is deposited by dripping water. The calcite forms stalactites on the roof of the cavern and stalagmites on the floor of the cavern. If you could look inside the Earth, you would see that it is made up of different layers. The top layer of the Earth is called the crust. The layer of rock just beneath the crust is called the mantle. Rocks found in the mantle are pressed tightly together, and some are partly melted. The layer below the mantle is called the outer core. The outer core is liquid rock. And below the outer core is the inner core. The inner core is solid. Both the inner core and the outer core are extremely hot, and both are mostly made of iron. Mountains, valleys, and even the ocean floor are all part of the Earth's crust. Most of the Earth's crust is made up of rock. Let's play a round of Know Your Rocks. Question number one. The basic building blocks of the Earth are A. Icons, B. Minerals, C. Oxygen and nitrogen, or D. None of the above. The correct answer is B. The basic building blocks of the Earth are minerals. Moving on to question number two. The top layer of Earth is called the A. Tropical zone, B. Stonemason, C. Outer core, or D. Crust. The correct answer is D. The top layer of Earth is called the crust. Moving on to question number three. The layer of Earth below the mantle is called the outer core. The outer core is made up of A. Heated charcoal, B. Liquid rock, C. Water and mud, or D. Dinosaur bones. The correct answer is B. The outer core is made up of liquid rock. Very good. Now there are three different types of rocks: igneous rock, sedimentary rock, and metamorphic rock. These different kinds of rocks are each formed in different ways. Let's begin with how igneous rock is formed. Igneous rock is formed from melted earth material called magma that forms inside the earth. Sometimes magma flows onto the earth's surface, usually from a volcanic eruption. When magma reaches the surface of the earth, we call it lava. Igneous rock is formed from cooled magma or lava. Some examples of igneous rock are granite, rhyolite, obsidian, and scoria, better known as lava rock. The second kind of rock we're going to look at is called sedimentary rock. Sedimentary rocks are formed from sediments. Sediments are tiny pieces of Earth's material, such as mud, sand, and clay, carried by wind or water. Over hundreds of thousands of years, the layers of sediment are pressed together to form rock. We call this type of rock sedimentary rock. Sedimentary rock is formed from compressed sediments. This picture shows different layers of sedimentary rock. Sometimes animals and plants may become covered with sediments and become fossils. Some sedimentary rock contains fossils. Coal is sedimentary rock that is made from plants that lived a long time ago. That's why coal is called a fossil fuel. The third kind of rock is called metamorphic rock. Metamorphic rock is rock that is changed by heat and pressure. For example, an igneous rock like granite can be changed to gneiss, a metamorphic rock. And a sedimentary rock like limestone changes through intense heat and pressure to form marble. You may think that rocks last forever, but they don't. Over time, rocks may change their shape, size, color, and texture. Well, did you ever see a tree growing out of a solid rock? Plants can change rocks. Sometimes soil will get into cracks in rocks and plants will start to grow. The roots push against the rock, and if the plant grows large enough, it can break the rock. Some animals change rocks by digging tunnels in the ground. As they dig, they loosen rocks and soil, allowing air and water to move in. People change rocks too. People dig tunnels, build roads, and cut rocks to build buildings and statues too. People can change rocks very quickly using machines, but in nature, the changes happen so slowly we can't detect them. But over a long period of time, rocks break into smaller parts. That's why you see signs on some roads that warn about falling rocks. Breaking rocks down into smaller pieces is called weathering, and it takes place all the time. Weathering is caused by wind, ice, and water. Moving water slowly wears rock down, especially if it carries sediment. An example of how water can wear rock away is the Grand Canyon. It's over 1 mile deep and 11 miles wide, and was carved out by the Colorado River. Another way water changes rocks is when the water freezes and turns to ice. Lots of rocks have cracks in them. Water flows into the cracks. When it gets cold outside and the water turns to ice, it expands, which splits the cracks in the rocks further apart. The cracks get bigger over time, and finally, they break the rock. Winds also weather rocks. Winds pick up and carry dust and sand, which scratch rocks and slowly wear them away. Sometimes wind-blown sediments weather rocks into unusual shapes. Erosion is the process by which wind and water wear away at rocks. When rocks are eroded, the final result is very small particles, which we call soil. Soil is typically the topmost layer of the Earth's rock layers, and soil differs from place to place. There are three types of soil: loam, sand, and clay. Loam is rich in decayed plants and animals, and it's the best type of soil for growing plants. While sand is made of large, loose grains of mineral quartz, sand cannot hold water, so it's not good for growing plants. Clay holds water very well. Usually there is too much water, so it's not good for growing plants. However, because it sticks together well, clay is a great material for making pottery. Let's play another round of Know Your Rocks. Question number one. When hot magma comes to the surface of the Earth, we call it A, sedimentary rock, B, minerals, C, lava, or D, none of the above. The correct answer is C. When hot magma comes to the surface of the Earth, we call it lava. Question number two. Breaking rocks down into smaller pieces is called weathering. Weathering is caused by A, trees and animals, B, wind, ice, and water, C, clouds and gravity, or D, all of the above. The correct answer is B. Weathering is caused by wind, ice, and water. Moving on to question number three. The process by which wind and water wear away at rocks is called A, erosion, B, liquidation, C, shaving, or D, none of the above. correct answer is A, the process by which wind and water wear away at rocks is called erosion. So, rocks are always changing. One kind of rock changes into a different kind of rock. We call the changing of rocks the rock cycle. Let's begin with igneous rocks. Weathering breaks down igneous rocks into small particles. Sediments are formed and pressed together to become sedimentary rock. Some igneous rocks are buried deep inside the earth where heat and pressure change the rocks to metamorphic rocks. Sedimentary and metamorphic rock are also changed by weathering. Sedimentary and metamorphic rocks buried deep inside the earth can change to igneous rocks or to other metamorphic rocks because of heat and pressure. There are lots of things that can affect the cycles of changes in rocks and soil. Wind, temperature, water, ice, and glaciers all cause the changes. It's the reason that landscapes all over the world look so different. It's the reason some places are mountainous and other places are deserts. Why some places are great for growing crops and other areas are rich in trees and woodlands. When you think about it, the rocks, minerals, and soil found in any one place on Earth tell a story of that place. You know that when you see a canyon, that rock has been eroded by water. When you see a rock in the woods, you know that it was probably left there by a glacier. Sand on the beach came from the constant weathering by the ocean. And igneous rock was formed from a volcanic eruption. In this program, we learned that rocks are formed from minerals, the basic building blocks of the Earth. We learned how rocks are formed and how rocks change. Rocks are found all over the world, and rocks are way cool.